35, 25, launch pass to Chambers is behind the back.
Did you ever think in your wildest dreams? I guess
KJ to Chambers, jam!
40 points in the first half for Tom Chambers.
Chambers to win the game. He's got it.
Welcome back to Tom Chambers' Greatest Games. In this episode, we go back to the 1987 NBA playoffs with the Seattle Supersonics facing defending Western Conference champions, the Houston Rockets. Having won the All-Star Game MVP during the regular season, Chambers would prove in this playoff series that it was no fluke, leading the Sonics to a surprising 3-1 series lead in this game after dropping 38 points on Ralph Sampson and the Rockets. Chambers ate Sampson alive in this game, as Sampson simply could not guard Chambers on the drive or defend Chambers' outside shooting, with Chambers almost toying with Sampson and Olajuwon late in the game. Chambers would be named player of the game and further solidify his new status as one of the elite players in the NBA. So let's go back to May 9th, 1987, the Seattle Supersonics versus the Houston Rockets in Game 4 of the 1987 Western Conference Semis.
Today, it's conference semifinal action from Seattle between the Houston Rockets and the Seattle Supersonics. McCray, Sampson, and Olajuwon, the front line for Houston. With Allen Leavell, the point guard, Robert Reid scoring from the point. Reid has not been strong against this ball club. Bill Fitch, the head coach, he's been to the title before. Experienced in playoff play. Chambers, McDaniel, and Johnson, the big front line, which has the assignment to slow down the big fellas from Houston. Dale Ellis has been the scoring key. And Bernie Bickerstaff, who was the assistant head coach at Washington when they won the title. The officials for today, Garrettson, Van Ax, and Jakes is the alternate. And right away a change. Alton Lister, who has been out with a fractured foot, gets the start today. Psychological ploy, I would think, Billy, by Bernie Bickerstaff as you look at the comparison of these two teams thus far.
Now, Bernie talked about coming back with Alton Lister, although he had been out with that fractured bone on his foot. I think he wants to give this team a lift and see if Lister can go ahead and play down inside with Hakeem Olajuwon early one-on-one.
Well, Lister wins the tap, gets the hand on the ball, but it is Allen Leavell of Houston that gains possession. Just underway, game four, the best of seven series.
Post up for Rodney McCray early.
Sampson had the jumper and takes it.
Nobody you'd like to see get off to a fast start if you're Bill Fitch than Ralph Sampson. That's what happened the other night and really set the pace. Back screen for Ellis. Nice lob. And he's fouled.
Houston leads 4-2. This is Chambers.
That's why he's an all-star. On one end, comes right back and takes it to Sampson, saying it's not going to be a day off today.
Chambers.
That's what makes it so tough to guard him. He can hit the outside shot. Sampson likes to go right out at him, and then Chambers will go around him.
Chambers sitting on the bench. Both have two personal fouls.
Went out with foul trouble early. Olajuwon only with 3 points, and Chambers with four. Hakeem, the number two scorer so far in the playoffs. Michael Jordan in that three-game series up around 35, but Hakeem right in there behind him. Feitl can hit that jumper.
This is Reid. There's eight on the shot clock.
Robert Reid.
And we're tied at 31.
No, that shot is no good.
So that's the end of the first period with a score. Houston 31, Seattle 31. Center Coliseum here in Seattle has a seating capacity of 14,200. Thursday night for game three, the attendance was 14,587, which means 387 people slipped in here somehow, some way. And I suspect today there are more people than that. Five turnovers thus far for the Rockets. Sampson is on fire. He's got 10 points. Ellis has 11 points. And Ellis, Billy Packer, was off Thursday night. It seems like he's been shooting his way out.
And look at who's coming back in here. Hakeem Olajuwon, very silent in that first quarter, picking up two quick fouls, only had 3 points.
Seattle jumps on it quickly, though.
Difficult to defend that long pass, and McCray really telegraphed that one.
Chambers. Bill Fitch wants a timeout.
Well, I'm not particularly happy with what has transpired to this point, because it shouldn't have been such as a hype as it was in Houston to begin with. I had told the Houston Rockets a long time ago they could have signed me early in the season if they wanted to or whatever, and then things didn't happen that way. I feel personally that I need to just forget about it and play, because I don't want to be going back and forth. Every reporter here, every reporter saying, are you going to be in Houston? And fans saying, are you going to be in Houston? Or are you going to be here? Or are you going to be there? I'm just going to let it go until after the season, and I'll make my decision after the season.
So Ralph Sampson wants to think about playing basketball. And Billy, you can see by the statistics on the board there that he's playing well today.
He is playing well, but with Hakeem out of the ball game, Seattle did an excellent job keeping Sampson in tow.
This is Kevin Williams to Chambers, and Chambers will fire from three-point range.
He wants to drive on Ralph.
Ralph knocks it away. Now, we talked about that yesterday with Ralph. We said that he tries to bait him and get him out there to overplay him so he can drive. As you look at the Lakers score, and they're running it up now against Golden State.
Well, Ralph was kind of humoring me a little bit when I kidded him about it. I said, you know, you got to make him make a couple of jump shots out there instead of going and charging him because he's too quick for you. He said, yeah, but when I let him alone, and then the management says, get out there and play somebody.
Chambers, a very good free throw shooter, 85%, but he too has trouble getting it in the hole. It finally drops after rattling around, and he now has 7 points.
Chambers led the club in free throw shooting this year. A la Larry Bird, another big man in the front line, led his team first guy in the history of the NBA.
Tim Brand and Billy Packer with you. The Rockets have turned the ball over 9 times. Seattle has a 10-2 run going against the Rockets as Hakeem Olajuwon.
It's going to be on Ralph Sampson.
Blocks the shot. The foul is on Sampson. And that is his third personal. Now Sampson has 12 points. And Ellis, Dale Ellis of Seattle, has 11 points. But more importantly, Ralph Sampson is now in some foul trouble.
Petersen is going to come in for Sampson. Petersen had to come in the first quarter. Hakeem Olajuwon has picked up two quick ones, so Houston hasn't been able to use the Twin Towers together for very many minutes today.
Hakeem Olajuwon had to sit out a good portion of the first period because he had two personals. He also now has three. And he has not really been playing well. He has an injured hand that became very swollen after Thursday's game three.
I don't think the hand has bothered Hakeem as much as Seattle's defense has prevented him from getting the ball down and low where he likes it. Not much he can do. He's got Sampson sitting on the bench with three.
Nice pass down.
Good touch base. Now, Chambers really saw level coming. Left McMillan open, who was one touch pass ahead to Ellis cutting to the basket. Good play.
Chambers working on Petersen.
Reid gets screened by...
Tough drive. Yes. And he's fouled.
Great drive. That's the second time today that Chambers has come back after his man took him inside and taken the ball to the hoop. The first time on Sampson, this time on Petersen. Sensational drive by Chambers.
Billy, there's a lot of foul trouble for Houston. Sampson, Hakeem Olajuwon, and Robert Reid all have three personals, and that could be trouble down the stretch.
A big, big differential for the simple reason Seattle much deeper on the bench with quality people and not afraid to use them.
Chambers rolls it in. He now has 13 points for Seattle. It's 50-40. Sonics. Chambers at the top of the key working against Petersen. He feels he can take him to the hoop. And
great
he does.
First step.
Chambers! 5 on the shot clock. This is Chambers again. Nice move out front. He scores.
Chambers! What Chambers did so effectively there, Tim, is he stayed outside where he's got good position to shoot that three-point shot. Nobody could help out on him. Then he made the good quick move to the basket when Petersen had to adjust.
Fitch wants a 20-second timeout.
Gets it off to Chambers. Seattle uses.
He comes back into the ball game, replacing Chambers.
Ellis with a great save.
That's the end of the half.
So that's the end of the first half with a score. Seattle 62, Houston 55. And James Brown will be back with a Prudential at the half after this message.
Starting lineup for your Seattle Supersonics. The head coach of the Supersonics, Bernie Bickerstaff.
I've really never been hung up into that star celebrity type of thing. I feel very comfortable and I feel competent. I want to give it my best shot and let things fall where they fall.
It rains a lot here in Seattle, so when the sun shines, it seems especially brilliant and beautiful. Like this city, Bernie Bickerstaff has learned to cope, to accept his share of hard times and rainy days. But right now, it's time to just enjoy some of the sunshine of success and recognition. For 12 long years, Bernie Bickerstaff served an apprenticeship, 12 long years as assistant for three Washington Bullets coaches, 12 long years before finally getting the job as head coach for the Supersonics.
It usually takes a little longer for a black coach to reach a level as opposed to a white coach. I think that's something that's very obvious.
Is it frustrating? Are you bitter about that?
No, I'm not bitter. I have the opportunity, and then I look at the situation that I sat there for 12 years, but it was a learning experience.
What Bickerstaff learned was patience. His Sonics were 31-51 last season and limped into the playoffs this year, losing their first game by 22 points.
Oh, I just wanted to prove that I was a good coach. I thought I tried to do too much. I had too much of a rein on them. And the one thing you don't want to do in this league is that you don't want to inhibit.
Took a three. How about that, baby?
All of a sudden, things turned around. The Sonics shocked Dallas in the playoffs opening round and now hold a surprising 2-1 edge on Houston.
When you look at the Dell Ellis's, the Kevin Williams, the Bernie Bickerstaffs, we were all people pursuing an opportunity, and once it was given to us, then we tried to take advantage of it, and so far, so good.
He gives all the credit to the guys, but he's a hell of a coach. You know, I call him super coach, but he ignores me.
He's also a super dad, making sure his kids experience life away from basketball.
I go and watch the games, and I hurt for them when things don't go right. So basically the thing that I try to convey to them, hey, make sure you go out and have fun and enjoy yourselves, because the pressure is definitely coming down the street.
Well, so far the pressure hasn't gotten to Bernie, not yet at least, and his season of triumph continues.
I really like it here. You know, you can get in the rocking chair and you can look at the snow-capped mountains, and it's peaceful. And believe me, in this profession, you need something peaceful to come home to.
Bernie Sunbernard, age 11, watching intently as his dad's team now has taken control of Houston here in game four, their best of seven.
And we are just about set to begin the second half. Tim Brandt and Billy Packer along with you from the Seattle Center Coliseum in Seattle, Washington. And the story thus far has been Dale Ellis and Tommy Chambers of Seattle. Both have had hot hands. And Billy Packer, I think it's interesting as you look at Chambers how hot he has been and how confident he seems to be about taking the ball against the Twin Towers.
Well, he only got in 14 minutes in the first half because he got in foul trouble right away, just as Hakeem Olajuwon, but 7 for 10, 5 for 5 from the free throw line, 19 points, all in 14 minutes. And he really has caused problems no matter who's tried to match up with him.
Ellis. Houston has climbed back to within 3 points. This is Ellis. This is Chambers on Sampson. Nice pump fake. Sampson fouls him.
Here's where Sampson gets caught with that pump fake.
Watch and grab.
With the right hand, you can't see it. But it is Sampson. It's his fourth.
Kevin Johnson replaces Alton this year for the
Bill center. Fitch keeps Ralph Sampson in. Bill Fitch looking over there across. Sampson got himself in trouble again by going for the pump fake. As Sampson is, you're better off staying on the ground. You're better off staying on the ground at all times, but particularly when you're in foul trouble, let Chambers take the jumper.
Chambers. Chambers and Sampson play mental games with each other. They bait each other, irritate each other. Right now, Chambers has the best of it. Country. Young uses up a lot of time at the top of the key. There's five on the shot clock.
Oh, great shot! Chambers! He's taking Sampson to school on an isolation.
Probably a pretty good matchup right now in the case of Houston. There's a double for Ellis. He's not taking it. Oh, Chambers is going crazy.
Chambers now has 27 points. The story of the game, Tom Chambers, way above his average and showing no signs of slowing up.
Well, Tim, he's way below his average, but not incapable of having a giant night. Chambers has had 42 as his high on the year. Ellis has had 41 and has had three nights over 40, and McDaniels has had a 40-point night. So they're all capable of those giant figures.
What's interesting, Billy, is that right now Chambers is 10 of 16 from the field. The last three playoff games prior to this one, he shot only 40% from the field. We're inside 5 seconds.
Lucas over Sampson's back. Now, that you got to put him out of the game for
here
that.
Here we go.
You got to put him out of the game for that. You remember earlier in the ball game when he took Leavell's head off? I don't think there's any place for that in basketball.
Sonics 86, Rockets 79. We'll return after this word from your local station. The story continues to develop. Seattle leads Houston 86-79. We are about to begin the fourth and final period in Seattle. At the conclusion of this game, Billy Packer and I will select the Miller Lite player of the game.
Two men have put on a show that puts them over 60, right?
29 points for Chambers. And he's had a bucket full of critical rebounds today.
Chambers!
Offensive rebounds putting Houston in trouble again. Ellis wanted Chambers for the solid screen.
What a drop by Chambers.
Petersen really having trouble matching up out there. Here we're going to see Chambers. Sits right down, pump fake. A little bit of walk on that play. He has a tendency to move both feet on that drive. Never called. But a super move to the basket by a 6'10 man that plays like he's 6'5.
Ellis over to Chambers. And a foul's going to be on Sampson.
Foul on Sampson.
Who are you going to see again, Tim? Where Ralph goes out and challenges Chambers at that far away from the basket. Not good defensive technique because Chambers thinks he can take him anyway. And he's not going to shoot the jump shot from out there with 2 minutes to go in a ball game.
One more foul, Ralph's gone. Chambers now has 34 points.
High on the year, 42.
More than everybody in the NBA except for just seven players.
There's a case of Chambers just feeling his oats. He's been able to take Ralph from the outside, protecting himself by grabbing the rim.
He's saying, in your face.
There he goes again. Right by Sampson.
Two shots for Chambers.
And that's an adjustment that Sampson, in watching these tapes, is going to have to make if they're going to stay alive in the rest of the series. But if you're Chambers, you're not going to change that technique at all against him.
Both players well aware of the fact that it was Ralph Sampson who was injured at All-Star time and couldn't go, so they brought in Chambers to take his place, and he became the MVP.
And starter in that ballgame.
It's been that kind of year for the Seattle Supersonics.
You know, way back in February 3rd, Pat Riley said, this team's going to start causing some problems around the league. Leavell's got to go to the three-point area. Team should get it back out to Reid, who had an easy three.
McCray with a rebound. Pump fake. And blocked by Chambers. This crowd can feel it.
And why is Grizzly spreading things out, looking for some backdoor cut.
Listen to this crowd. Chambers is fouled again. It's on Sampson. He'll sit down. That tells the story. Seattle is a team, Billy, built of two rookies. Seven players who arrived this season either by trade or free agency. Two veterans, Xavier, McDaniel.
Tom Chambers goes to the top of the key to congratulate him. Chambers was a fella earlier in his career that people said was very selfish. But he's taken a fine leadership role with this club now.
Ellis takes a seat with 36 points. Correction, Ellis leads with 32 and Chambers has 37.
So here's a chance to go over 60. I thought they were there a minute or so ago.
A 20-second timeout.
And that's what Lister did today in the early going for the Sonics.
Tom Chambers leads the ball game with 38 points.
Team Olajuwon leads the game.
We've got 3 seconds remaining in the ball game. This has been a very physical game. Teppers have flared. Both teams were hot. Tom Chambers was hot physically, mentally, and ended with 38 points.
And Dennis, these clubs play, when they play their next game, if you're Houston, you want the game to be closely called because foul problems did not get in the way of the Sonics, where it really caused problems for Houston today.
Has taken a 3-game-to-1 lead, winning this one 117-102. Our Miller Lite player of the game is Tom Chambers, who ended with 38 points and 8 rebounds. Miller is proud to present a check for $1,000 to the Multiple Sclerosis Society on behalf of Tom Chambers. Once again, the final score was Seattle 117, Houston 102. The NBA on CBS is a presentation of CBS Sports.